wondered what happens when the Earth decides to play a game of tectonic twister? Well, buckle up, because we're about to dive into the wild world of the San Andreas Fault, nature's very own geological roller coaster. Imagine you're standing in California, minding your own business, when suddenly the ground beneath your feet starts to rumble. No, it's not your stomach protesting that fourth taco. It's the San Andreas Fault saying, "Hello, Earthlings." This isn't just any old crack in the ground. It's a superstar in the world of geology, stretching over 800 miles through the Golden State. That's like 13,333 football fields lined up end to end. Talk about a long-distance relationship between two tectonic plates. Now, you might be thinking, great, another thing that could kill me in California, alongside wildfires, mudslides, and kale smoothies. But hold on to your avocado toast, because the San Andreas Fault isn't all doom and gloom. In fact, it's a bit like that eccentric aunt who shows up at family gatherings. Sure, she might shake things up a bit, but she also brings some pretty amazing gifts to the party. Let's rewind the clock about 30 million years. That's when two of Earth's tectonic plates, the Pacific plate and the North American plate, decided they had enough of being neighbors and started to drift apart. Imagine two gigantic puzzle pieces slowly sliding past each other, and you've got the basic idea. This epic game of plate tectonic tag created what we now know as the San Andreas Fault. But here's where it gets really interesting. This fault isn't just a simple line drawn through California. Oh no, it's more like a drunken scribble made by a giant toddler with a crayon. It zigs, it zags, it loops and swoops from the Mendocino coast in the north all the way down to the Salton Sea in the south. Along the way, it's carved out some of the most breathtaking landscapes you'll ever see. Take the Carrizo Plain, for example. This place looks like someone took a giant knife and sliced right through the Earth's crust. You can literally see where the ground has shifted, creating what geologists call a linear valley. It's like a Mother Nature's version of a before and after photo, showing off her mad landscaping skills. Or how about the Pinnacles National Park? This place is what you get if you asked a bunch of rocks to play Jenga. The San Andreas Fault has punched and pulled the land here so much that it's created towering spires and deep canyons. It's a rock climber's paradise and a geologist's playground all rolled into one. Now, I know what you're thinking, but what about the earthquakes? Well, yes, the San Andreas Fault is famous for its shake, rattle, and roll. The 1906 San Francisco earthquake? That was the San Andreas Fault's handiwork. But here's a mind-bending fact for you. The big one that everyone in California fears? It's not a matter of if, but when. The southern part of the fault is like a wound-up spring, storing energy for over 300 years. When it finally lets loose, it'll be like nothing we've ever seen before. But let's not get too caught up in the doom and gloom. The San Andreas Fault isn't just about destruction, it's also a creator. It's like the ultimate sculptor, constantly reshaping the land around it. Mountains rise, valleys deepen, and entire ecosystems are born, all thanks to this restless crack in the Earth's surface. Think about it this way. Without the San Andreas Fault, California would be as flat as a pancake. No majestic Sierra Nevada mountains, no stunning coastal cliffs, no fertile Central Valley. It's like the fault line is California's personal trainer, constantly pushing and pulling to keep the landscape in shape. The San Andreas Fault is moving surprisingly fast, geologically speaking. The Pacific plate is sliding northwest relative to the North American plate at about 2 inches per year. That might not sound like much, but give it a few million years, and Los Angeles might find itself knocking on San Francisco's door. But the San Andreas Fault isn't just about rocks and earthquakes. This fault line is actually a major player in shaping the incredible biodiversity of California. It's like the ultimate matchmaker, bringing together different types of rocks, soils, and landscapes to create a patchwork of unique habitats. Imagine you're a tiny seed floating on the wind. Thanks to the San Andreas Fault, you might land in a lush forest one minute, a dry desert the next, or even a coastal meadow. It's like nature's version of a choose-your-own-adventure story, and every plant and animal gets to play. Let's talk about mountains. The San Andreas Fault has been pushing and shoving for millions of years, creating some of California's most iconic mountain ranges. The San Gabriel Mountains, for instance, are like the fault's personal art project. These mountains are rising faster than a souffle in a pressure cooker, about 1 millimeter per year. That might not sound like much, but in geological terms, it's like the mountains are on steroids. Do you know any interesting facts about the San Andreas Fault? I would love to read about them in the comments below. As these mountains rise, they're not just creating pretty postcards, they're creating entirely new habitats. It's like the fault line is playing SimCity, but with real ecosystems. You've got alpine meadows at the top, dense forests on the slopes, and chaparral shrublands at the base. Each of these zones is home to a unique cast of plant and animal characters, all thanks to the San Andreas Fault's landscaping skills. Now, let's talk about soil. I know, soil sounds about as exciting as watching paint dry. But trust me, in the world of biodiversity, soil is the unsung hero. The San Andreas Fault is like a giant blender mixing up different types of rocks and minerals. In some areas, you might find rich volcanic soil that's perfect for growing giant redwoods. A few miles away, you could stumble upon sandy soil that's ideal for drought-resistant plants. It's like the fault line is running its own botanical garden, providing the perfect home for an incredibly diverse range of plant species. To add to the awesomeness, the San Andreas Fault isn't just creating diverse habitats on land, it's also shaping the coastline. As the Pacific Plate grinds past the North American Plate, it's creating a series of headlands and bays that look like someone took a giant bite out of California. These varied coastal habitats are like an all-you-could-eat buffet for marine life. From kelp forests teeming with otters to rocky tide pools full of starfish and anemones. Ready to dive into the fault's coolest trick? Introducing creating microclimates. Thanks to the mountains and valleys carved out by the San Andreas Fault, you can experience several different climates in the span of just a few miles. These microclimates are biodiversity hotspots. They're like nature's incubators, allowing species to evolve and adapt to very specific conditions. It's survival of the fittest on a micro scale, and it's led by some pretty bizarre and wonderful creatures. Take the Mount Diablo buckwheat, for example. This little plant was thought to be extinct for 69 years until it was rediscovered in 2005. It only grows in a tiny area on Mount Diablo, which was pushed up by, you guessed it, the San Andreas Fault. This plant is so rare and specialized that its entire world population could fit on a couple of tennis courts. Or how about the California condor? These massive birds with a wingspan that could give a small airplane a run for its money rely on the updrafts created by the fault-formed mountains to soar and search for food. Without the San Andreas Fault, these majestic birds might never have evolved their impressive flying skills. But it's not just about creating new habitats. The San Andreas Fault is also a master of transformation. As it moves, it can turn forests into grasslands, lakes into valleys, and hills into mountains. It's like a geological magician, constantly pulling new ecosystems out of its hat. This constant change keeps evolution on its toes. Species have to adapt or die, leading to some pretty incredible specializations. The California slender salamander, for instance, has evolved into over 20 different species, each adapted to a specific microhabitat created by the fault's landscaping. And let's not forget about the plants. The California poppy, with its brilliant orange flowers, has adapted to thrive in the disturbed soils often found along the fault lines. It's like these flowers are nature's way of putting a bright, cheery bandage on the Earth's wounds. But perhaps one of the most mind-blowing aspects of the San Andreas Fault's influence on biodiversity is its role in creating ecological islands. As the fault moves, it can isolate populations of plants and animals, cutting them off from their relatives. Over time, these isolated populations can evolve into entirely new species. It's like the fault line is running its own evolutionary experiment, creating real-life versions of the Galapagos Islands right in California's backyard. The result is a treasure trove of endemic species, plants, and animals found nowhere else on Earth. Still with me? Let's talk about the San Andreas Fault's greatest hit, habitat diversity. This geological guitar string has strummed up an incredible array of ecosystems. We're talking more variety than a box of assorted chocolates, but instead of pralines and truffles, we've got redwood forests, coastal scrublands, and everything in between. Take the Point Reyes National Seashore, for example. This peninsula is literally on the move, sliding northwest along the fault at a blistering pace of, drumroll please, about 2 inches per year. Okay, so it's not exactly breaking any speed records, but give it a few million years and it might be waving hello to Alaska. This slow motion journey has created a mosaic of habitats, from windswept beaches to dense forests, all packed into one relatively small area. It's like Mother Nature's version of a mullet. Beach party in the front, forest business in the back. But it's not just about quantity, it's quality too. The San Andreas Fault has created some seriously unique habitats that are home to species you won't find anywhere else on Earth. It's like the fault line is running its own exclusive ecological nightclub, and only the coolest, most specialized species get past the velvet rope. For instance, let's chat about the Hickman's Potentilla. This tiny yellow flower is only found in a few spots along the San Andreas Fault Zone. It's so rare that if you blink, you might miss its entire world population. Talk about exclusive. Or how about the San Francisco garter snake? This dazzling reptile with its red, black, and turquoise stripes looks like it was designed by a colorblind fashion designer on a caffeine binge. It's only found in a small area near, you guessed it, the San Andreas Fault. It's so rare and fabulous that it's been called the most beautiful serpent in North America. Move over, Taylor Swift. There's a new snake queen in town. Now you might be thinking, great, so we've got some cool plants and animals. Why should I care? Well, buckle up, Buttercup, because we're about to dive into the world of ecosystem services. These are the freebies that nature provides us, and trust me, they're better than any Black Friday deal. The diverse ecosystems along the San Andreas Fault are working overtime to keep California running smoothly. Those forests? They're not just pretty to look at, they're also nature's air purifiers, sucking up carbon dioxide and pumping out fresh oxygen faster than you can say climate change. The wetlands created by the fault's movement? They're like giant sponges, soaking up excess water and reducing the risk of floods. It's like having a free insurance policy against natural disasters. But wait, there's more. The fault-formed landscapes also play a crucial role in water purification. As water trickles through different rock and soil types, it gets filtered and cleaned. It's like the Earth's kidneys, but way cooler and with better views. And let's not forget about pollination. The diverse plant species supported by the fault's varied habitats attract a wide range of pollinators. It's like a singles mixer for bees, butterflies, and flowers, ensuring that California's agriculture stays productive. Without these pollinators, your avocado toast might become an endangered breakfast species. Now I know what you're thinking. This all sounds great, but isn't the San Andreas Fault also, you know, kind of dangerous? Well, you're not wrong. The same forces that create all this biodiversity can also shake things up, literally. What's fascinating is that some species have actually adapted to depend on these disturbances. Take the fire poppy, for example. This flower is like the phoenix of the plant world. It needs fire to germinate its seeds. The wildfires that sometimes follow earthquakes, they're not just destruction. They're also a rebirth for these resilient flowers. It's nature's way of saying, when life gives you earthquakes, make poppies. But let's face it, as cool as all this biodiversity is, it's also under threat. Urban development, climate change, and invasive species are all putting pressure on these unique ecosystems. It's like watching your favorite TV show get canceled just as it was getting to the good part. That's where conservation efforts come in. Scientists, park rangers, and nature enthusiasts are working tirelessly to protect these special habitats. It's like they're running an ecological witness protection program, ensuring that rare species don't disappear forever. For instance, the Save the Redwoods League is working to protect and restore redwood forests, many of which are found in fault-influenced landscapes. These trees aren't just big and beautiful, they're also champion carbon sequesters. Protecting them is like giving the Earth a giant tree-shaped inhaler to help it breathe easier. There's also the Point Reyes National Seashore Association, which is dedicated to preserving the diverse habitats of Point Reyes. They're like the bouncers at nature's exclusive nightclub, making sure all the VIP species, very important plants and animals, are protected. But conservation isn't just about hands-off preservation. Sometimes it involves actively managing landscapes. Controlled burns, for instance, can help maintain the diversity of fire-adapted ecosystems. It's like giving nature a carefully monitored spa day. A little heat can do wonders for rejuvenation. Research is another crucial part of conservation efforts. Scientists are constantly studying the unique ecosystems along the San Andreas Fault, trying to understand how they work and how best to protect them. It's like they're ecological detectives, piecing together the mysteries of nature one DNA sample at a time. And here's where you come in, dear viewer. Conservation isn't just for scientists in white coats or rangers in funny hats. It's for everyone who has ever looked at a flower and thought, wow, that's pretty neat. You can help by supporting conservation organizations, volunteering for habitat restoration projects, or simply by treading lightly when you visit these special places. Remember, the San Andreas Fault isn't just a crack in the ground. It's a creator of worlds, a sculptor of landscapes, and a guardian of biodiversity. It's proof that sometimes the most amazing things come from the Earth's deepest wounds. So, next time you feel the ground shake a little, don't just think about ducking and covering. Take a moment to appreciate the incredible force that's shaping the world around you, one earthquake at a time. And who knows? Maybe millions of years from now, some future species will evolve to thrive in the ruins of our cities, turning our forgotten skyscrapers into vertical forests or our abandoned highways into rivers. Life finds a way, and thanks to forces like the San Andreas Fault, it finds many, many fascinating ways. So, here's to the fault. May it keep shaking things up for millions of years to come. I love talking about this topic today. So if you felt the same way, go ahead and click on that like button and subscribe. And see you next time. Stay insanely curious.